Tonight, men across America have been faced with mood swings, lack of libido, and chocolate cravings. We have more on this tragic epidemic.
Later, well, the earth is melting, and the hormonal male students in New Gartland could be to blame.
Plus, in one of the biggest breakups since Rachel and Ross, does the United States have a new bae by its side? We'll fill you in. Howdy, Earthlings. I'm No Name, and I'm searching for the Claw.
And I'm Rick Pizza, the pizza dude from the pizza plant around the corner. I was supposed to just drop off some pies, but I'm here, so... We are grateful in news this week as any further research of birth control for men have been disbanded by the FDA. Apparently, this medicine drastically alters men's hormones with the risk to side effects such as mood swings, acne, weight gain, nausea, and cramps. The FDA has deemed these hazardous possibilities as unsafe for the already fragile male population. Average college frat boy Justin Longboard has reached out saying, "I just can't handle the risk of getting acne." Anyways, female birth control has no side effects. America's sleeping sound tonight with the relief that men will never have to go through these potential threats.
Students were forced to leave their dorms in New Gartland early Monday morning. What was said to be carbon monoxide leak was actually an overwhelming pollution cloud created by college boy Axe spray. After police collected over 300 empty cans of men's Axe body spray throughout the dorm building, a ban for any type of adolescent male perfume or cologne has been put forward. Students were not allowed to back in the building for 4 hours until the SWAT team was able to remove any trace of boy stank. Climate change activist Leonardo DiCaprio spoke up saying, "Marist frat boys are the reason for global warming."
The American government issued a press release on Tuesday stating that the U.S. democracy are, quote, on a break. Sources say that in recent months, the two simply haven't been compatible. There have been communication issues and trust issues, and the relationship simply isn't healthy anymore. The U.S. said it's going to take some time for itself and experiment with other types of government, including, but not limited to, anarchy, tyranny, and communism. When asked about the relationship status, the U.S. said it needed this time to, quote, find itself.
In more local news, Dylan Gordon, our very own news director here at MCTV, is being fired. In an elaborate plot to sabotage Dylan and his new Thomas Roberts internship, former news director Peter Malavenda leaked Dylan's violent texts to his friends Curtis that are too graphic for television. But what we will tell you is that they had to do with a hamster, a cantaloupe, a Russian, and some Cheerios. When Dylan and his friend Curtis were asked what it was about, Dylan simply replied, "You forgot Betty Crocker," before winking at the camera. MCTV President Andrew Ogier and former news director Peter Malavenda feel as if Dylan is no longer fit to be involved with news and are awaiting his resignation before the end of the semester.
Well, I don't know why we have to report on this because you could literally just look outside, but here's Rachel Tyson with the weather.
Hello, and welcome to this week's Lows and Lows Report. I'm Rachel Tyson. For this week, the eastern coast of the United States will be experiencing some off-kilter weather temperatures due to climate change and global warming. Although the co-founder of the Weather Channel, John Coleman, has said that climate change is no longer scientifically credible, the theory that carbon dioxide is a significant greenhouse gas and is causing severe weather effects has been proven time and time again. Let's take a look at those flip-flopping weather changes occurring in Poughkeepsie this week. As for today, we are currently experiencing thunderstorms, with temperatures reaching a high of 75 and a low of 67. Thursday, the Hudson Valley area will experience a blizzard starting at around 8 a.m. with up to 2 feet of snowfall. This precipitation will carry into the afternoon of Friday with high temperatures of 25 and a low of 12 degrees. Friday and Saturday, the temperature will skyrocket at an all-time high temperature of 103 degrees and 80% humidity. Sunday, you can expect hail the size of minivans, so folks, please remember to put your cars in a sheltered area. On Monday, you can expect the sky to rain cats and dogs, literally, between the hours of 3 p.m. and 5 p.m., so please make sure to leave a few blankets out in the yard for them to land on gracefully. Rounding off our week on Tuesday, Poughkeepsie and the surrounding area will experience absolutely perfect weather for a date or romantic stroll because it won't be too cold or too hot, and all you'll need is a light jacket. That's all I have for you today for the Lows and Lows Report. But remember, this week is a clear example that global warming and climate change are real in the Hudson Valley. I'm Rachel Tyson.
Groundhog Day is a tradition of winter, where Punxsutawney Phil comes out and kind of just looks around, and then the world takes the word of a feral animal to tell us what season it is. But as with everything in this current election season, nothing can be that simple. At a press conference via Skype last Thursday, the groundhog confirmed that he will not be coming out to look for his shadow if Donald Trump is elected president. The groundhog said, "What's the point anyway? I'm not stepping outside to see the orphans crying and to possibly get radiation poisoning. Look at your own shadow this year." The groundhog then took another puff of his cigarette and went on record that he was voting for Bill Murray this year.
To say that this election was crazy would be an understatement. Now, things have taken a turn for the weird when Virginian resident Clayton Litton found Donald Trump's face in his bathroom tile and reports the tile spoke to him. According to police reports, the Trump tile said to build a wall. Litton took this as a good sign and is currently in construction of a 10-foot wall around his humble abode. People from around the country have traveled to Litton's home to see the miraculous talking Trump tile. Reports have been released of people leaving gifts for the Trump tile and praying around it. Does this make Trump the next coming of Christ?
This week in world news, or should I say, outer-worldly news, the attempted Mars landing of a new probe from earlier this month has been abducted by aliens. In recent radio communications with living beings from the planet Peperosperini, the European Space Agency has been informed of the stolen spacecraft. There is no evidence of the craft ever touching base on Mars, but many indications of alien abduction include foreign markings that resemble pizza on the surface of Mars, where the craft was projected to land. The ESA is working to reach the planet Peperosperini to achieve lost vessel in 2020.
This morning, rapper and entrepreneur Snoop Dogg has teamed up with NASA to explore a planet that is supposedly covered in luscious fields of marijuana plants. The American government believes Mr. Dog is the only one up for this task of traveling to another dimension, 300 million light years away. Medical botanist and former Iron Chef Martha Stewart has leaked information that she may be accompanying Snoop Dogg on this high-flying trip. So look out next year, because Mission 420 will be making its debut launch.
Although Republican presidential candidate Donald Trump and Democratic presidential candidate Hillary Clinton don't seem to hit it off, their children were seen getting along pretty well with each other on Monday night. Chelsea Clinton and Ivanka Trump have taken up a new hobby of dancing together in public. The two were seen doing various dances, including Juju on That Beat, The Running Man, The Sprinkler, and The Dab. Maybe the two getting along will teach their parents a lesson about learning to accept each other's differences.
Also, don't know why we have to report on this, because you could literally just turn on the TV or something. But here's Andrew Ogier with your entertainment news. Are you
kidding? What? Sorry. Boo beat Inferno at the box office, Doctor Strange and Trolls coming out this weekend, Walking Dead still killing people with reckless abandon. That looks like the face of a guy who's hiding something. Anything else? Did I miss anything else? Okay. Whatever.
Every year when our very own MCTV seniors leave, their positions must be replaced. With Dylan quickly on his way out, it is only natural that co-director Aaron Murtha is next. Taking the reins of news next year are Molly Gamache and Sarah Shaddis and Jamie Cornelia, who are all reportedly under investigation for Aaron's disappearance. Aaron was last seen on Snapchat actively pursuing a clown, saying, "Your nose is so fluffy, I want it," and then turning on a dime and running in the opposite direction when he pulled out a slice of provolone cheese. But how could the clown have known that Aaron has an irrational fear of cheese? Only those close to Aaron are aware of this phenomenon. Molly was found with a red clown wig under her car seat, and Sarah was found with a machete. The investigation is still ongoing, but we don't think Aaron will be back anytime soon. She hates cheese so much. I don't think a clown was even necessary to get her to quit.
According to lifestyle expert Dr. Formaggi, who studied nutrition at the University of Wisconsin, it is beneficial to eat at least one slice of pizza per day. In a recent study conducted by Formaggi, he found that college students who eat pizza every day are happier in life and more likely to pass their classes than those who eat less than the recommended one slice. Formaggi indicates in his study that the pizza can be of any type and eaten at any time to be effective. This is all big news for both college students and the pizza industry alike.
Breaking news. Donald Trump has actually said something nice about women for once. Yesterday, Mr. Trump came forward saying that he thought Secretary Hillary Clinton was psych. We had you on that one for a second, didn't we? No, Mr. Trump is still quite misogynistic and has nothing but mean things to say about his opponent in the upcoming election. Who knows, maybe after the election over, he'll be sportsmanlike and grab Mrs. Clinton's hand and shake it.
Apple has released a sneak peek of the new emojis over the weekend, and people are devastated. The beloved peach emoji no longer looks like a butt, and avid texters around the nation are in a complete state of shock. Angry protesters have changed their hate Trump signs to, "We miss the old peach emoji." Hillary Clinton has since spoken and disclosed a statement reading that if she is elected, the emoji will be changed back to the original suggestive fruit. But for now, rest in peach, our treasured explicit emoji.
I'm very upset right now and think after that story, I'm going to have to toss it over to our sports guy to let us know what's going on in the world of sports.
Shooting hoops to the Super Bowl. We like sports and we don't care who knows. Football and ball.
Great toss, guys. Going along with this show's theme of pizza, I'm Mike Pizza with your sports update. We had a jam-packed weekend of sports as Sunday marked the 16th time ever where the NBA, NFL, MLB, and NHL were all in action. The big highlight of the weekend was the World Series as the Cleveland Indians took a 3-1 series lead before the Cubs came back to win the past two games and force a Game 7 in Cleveland. But the games were not the only action that occurred during the World Series. During Game 3 on Friday night, the game was stalled for Cleveland Indians first baseman Mike Napoli, who had an issue with his glove and came onto the field late during the third inning. Now, not everyone thought that that's why he was late to the field, as many fans went to Twitter saying that Napoli's base was loaded and was in the bathroom pooping. This assumption was completely wrong, but Napoli managed to have some fun with it, tweeting a gif of Elmo dancing on the toilet after the game. Then on top of the Napoli incident, during Game 5, everyone saw Cubs pitcher John Lester shooting snot rockets during the game on national television. I'm sure there are Cub fans out there who would have waited 100 more years to see the Cubs in a World Series if it meant they didn't have to see Lester shooting snot rockets. And now for a fitting story, seeing that Halloween was this past weekend. The always entertaining Los Angeles Laker met a world peace, claimed during a team visit to a haunted Oklahoma City hotel that ghosts in the hotel inappropriately touched him. World peace told reporters that the ghost touched him all over, and he just accepted it. And he was taking one of the ghosts to court. This led to other Lakers such as Lou Williams and Larry Nance Jr. booking rooms at other hotels instead. Whether this story was true or not, Meta World Peace will still be giving hugs to blind puppies next Tuesday. In the NFL, the Giants were on a bye week, the Jets just squeezed by the Browns, and the Pats beat the Bills behind Tom Brady's 4 touchdowns. And yes, there was another tie as the Redskins and Bengals tied on Sunday, making it the second week in a row that there's been a tie in the NFL. As for hockey, who cares unless you're Canadian or you're Andrew Ogé? That'll do it for sports. I'm Mike Pizza, and remember, ball is life.
Now feed me the rock. Now give me the rock.
Halloween might be over, but the candy craze continues. Hunter Jobins, a student at Kansas State University, had a Kit Kat bar stolen from his car. But instead of taking the treat with a trick, he left a note for Jobins. The note reads, "Saw Kit Kat in your cup holder. I love Kit Kats, so I checked your door and it was unlocked. Did not take anything other than the Kit Kat. I'm sorry and hungry." So what would you do for a Kit Kat bar?
In entertainment news, a congratulation is in order to the kid with the white Vans. On Tuesday, Daniel proposed to his girlfriend of 3 weeks at Zion National Park in Utah. Daniel met this girlfriend in a coffee shop when she complimented him on his good looks and white sneakers and keen sense of style. He proposed to her with a beautifully sculpted ring pop hidden inside of a new pair of white Vans. Family sources say that their wedding ceremony will take place at the Vans headquarters in Cypress, California, surrounded by their friends, families, fans, and thousands of white Vans. I guess all that's left to say is, damn, Daniel, back at it again with the white Vans.
Forget taking a cab to Darby's this weekend, because the beloved bar will be closed until further notice due to a recent health inspection. Darby O'Gill's experienced a harsh review from the feared Mr. What's It To Ya yesterday afternoon. The inspector found traces of urine in their nacho cheese, a collection of drunk girl tears turned vodka, and a party of underage students sitting at the bar during the examination. The bar is hoping to clean up its act and avoid having to reopen as Dirty O'Gill's. Honestly, that went a lot better than I expected, especially after last weekend when you...
Stop.
What?
Stop. We said we wouldn't talk about that anymore. Well, thank you for tuning in to MCTV News, your most trusted media source. I'm...
And I'm Rick the Pizza Dude. Good night.
Spaghetti. Knees weak, arms spaghetti. There's vomit on his sweater. Spaghetti. Mom's spaghetti. He's nervous, but on the surface, he looks calm. Spaghetti to drop bombs, but he keeps on spaghetti. What he wrote down, the whole crowd goes spaghetti. He opens his mouth, but spaghetti won't come out. He's choking. How? Everybody's choking now. Spaghetti's run out. Time's up. Over. Loud. Snap back to spaghetti. Oh, there goes spaghetti. Oh, there goes spaghetti. Loud. He's so mad, but he won't give up spaghetti. No.